Hello friends, and welcome back to r/entitledpeople, your one-stop shop for the world's most entitled humans. In today's stories, as you know from the title, the first one is about a Karen throwing milk at a store employee. Unlucky for her though, what comes around goes around. The second story is about someone that has a total man-child of a husband. And the last one is about another Karen who seems to think she's royalty and the cashiers helping her are mere peasants. But first, here's your daily dose of an anti-masker getting arrested.
Well then you have to abide by the rules. And you have to have a mask on. It's not. Businesses have the right to refuse service, even if you're not wearing a mask. That's their choice. Awesome. Well, you need to go and get a mask and then take your money out. You're not allowed to do. Ma'am, listen, we're going to do this the easy way or the hard way.
What are you going to do, arrest me?
Yes. Anytime. Wonder system.
Back up. Some old lady is getting handcuffed here. Oh, well, I was 6 feet away from those people
in
there, too.
In there. Get inside.
Come on, you guys. Let's get real.
What are you gonna do? Arrest me? Yeah, that's kind of my job. Alright guys, let's get into the stories, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more daily Reddit videos. This one's titled, No Lady, I Don't Want Your Milk. So this is a story from a few years ago when I used to work in the shipping and receiving department of a large grocery store chain. One of the people I loved working with there, we'll call him Bob, had an especially short fuse. Bob had worked in shipping and receiving for about 6 years by this point, and hated it and the people that shopped there. And I can't blame him either. I'm telling you all this because since I liked Bob, and since I generally was harder to piss off, anytime a customer would wander into the back looking for something or someone, I'd usually be the one to deal with them. No big deal, I really didn't mind it. But one summer's day, it was literally 110 degrees in the back of the truck we were unloading. And our manager was yelling at us every 15 minutes to go faster, and would retreat back to his air-conditioned office. So as you can imagine, we were all already in a bad mood. All of a sudden, we hear it. The dreaded sound everybody hates hearing. The dreaded, excuse me, coming from a Karen. Now this Karen looked to be around 60 or 70 years old, dressed extremely well, had a perm, I mean the whole thing. Right as I looked at her, I noticed she is carrying a milk jug that's leaking heavily, everywhere. So I look at Bob and tell him, I got this, and start to walk over to the Karen. I tell her, I'm sorry, but you can't be back here, as this is an employees only section. And she starts screaming at me and says, well, I wouldn't have to come back here if anybody here had any brain cells. I found this milk jug in an aisle, unrefrigerated, and I decided that I'm going to bring it back here to do you guys a favor, since none of you can do your jobs. Visibly already done with this, I try to put on my best customer service smile and say, well, we appreciate you bringing it to our attention, but in the future, if you could leave it where it is and ask an employee outside of this room to help, we would really appreciate it. Karen looks at me, shocked, like I just told her that she wasn't allowed to do whatever she wanted, and that I was insulting her for doing her good deed. Before I know it, she starts screaming at me that I'm an ungrateful little brat for not accepting her help, and then does something that shocked everyone. She says, "Do you want the milk back?" And I said, "Sure." And when I put my hand out to grab it, she effing throws it at my head. Absolutely shocked that I just got whacked with milk, I'm speechless. Which turns out didn't matter because before I could even react, here comes Bob. Remember how I said Bob hated this job and had a very short temper? Well, guess this was the day where he was like, F it. Because without saying anything, this man comes over, picks up the milk, and throws it back at her with speeds you only see from a quarterback in a playoff game. And then tells her, you dumb f***ing c***t. Are you really that f***ing stupid? This man was trying to help you out and be nice, and you have the f***ing nerve to throw this at him. You tracked half a gallon's worth of milk from where you found it to in here just to be a c***t. Next time you want to do us a favor, just don't. Because I don't think your dumb ass could. Get the f*** out of the back of this store and leave us the f*** alone. Now if you thought I was speechless before, you hadn't seen anything till now. I mean, I must have looked like a statue. I was almost afraid to move at the risk of getting my own head ripped off. But the lady just turns around and waddles away really fast. I turned around and realized it's not just me that is speechless. All five other guys on that shift that day are just looking at Bob with their mouths on the floor. I look at Bob and say, I appreciate it, man, but I really hope you didn't go too far. She might try to get you fired. And that's where Bob smiles and says, no, it's fine. There's no cameras back here because the company is cheap, and I've got all of you to back me up and say you have no idea what happened. I smiled. The rest of the group smiled. No one said anything. We all just smiled like we're all mentally agreeing that we won't say crap. As you can imagine, 10 minutes later, here comes at least 10 managers with this old lady in tow right behind them. She begins to say, "It was him. He did it." And we all just look at this lady with a shocked look, like we had no idea what was going on. She goes through the whole scene that happened, and we're all just like, "What the hell? None of that happened." I step up and say, "Bob never even talked to this lady. We have no idea what she's saying. I talked to her. She brought back a milk that was leaking everywhere, and I decided to bite my tongue and still be nice to this lady and take it. I asked her to exit the back of the store because it was an employees-only section, and she left. That was it. That's all that happened. You can check the cameras back here if you don't believe us." And my manager looks at me and says, "Well, we don't have cameras back here, but regardless, they are right, miss. You aren't supposed to be back here, ever. We have lots of signs posted for it on the door." As you can imagine, this lady gets even more irritated, screeching like a banshee to the point that no one can understand what she's even saying. My managers eventually just think she must be crazy and escort her out the store. They give us the whole, "Just make sure you try to watch your tone of voice more with customers for future reference talk." But besides that, nothing happened. The woman couldn't prove anything, and we all vouched for Bob, and the managers trusted me. They thought I'd never lie to them, because like I said, I'm usually the nice person who's trying to help anyone and everyone. Am I saying that it was right what we did? No, not at all. In retrospect, we probably went too far, but at the time, none of us gave a crap. We were done with Karen and her crap. We were already pissed from the heat and our other manager who was an arrogant dick. This lady just pushed us over the edge that day. So lady, if you're reading this, we are sorry, but maybe don't throw milk at people and act like a Karen if you don't want to get milk thrown back at you. This is so satisfying, you guys. You can tell that this is probably someone that's been able to act like this their whole life and just get away with it because no one's ever stepped up to them. But not today. Today she realized, wait, my behavior might actually have repercussions. I can't actually just treat people however I want. Something also tells me that she specifically thinks that she can do this to store employees because she knows that people won't do anything back because they don't want to get fired, which is a pretty cowardly move to pick on people that you know won't fight back because they'll risk their job. So thank you, Bob, for standing up for all workers that have to just stay silent and put up with this kind of stuff so we can continue to put food on the table. You're a hero. This one's called Toddler Husband. This is a secondhand story, but I wanted to share. So my mom's friend is a young woman, and she's married to a 30-year-old douchebag. This woman is struggling with her weight, so lately she started hanging out to walk with her friends for around 2 hours while her kid is in daycare. Well, her husband is demanding that, now that she's not working, has to spend all day at home. This is because Mr. Douchebag is very demanding about having the house absolutely spotless. Mind you, you have a little kid and a dog. But he is certainly not cleaning up himself. But the funny thing is, the one that got me to choke on my food while laughing is that he told her, "When I get home from work, I want my Colacao on the table." If you're wondering, Colacao is a Spanish brand of a chocolate drink, which you can buy powder and make it yourself at home with milk. So this guy, this grown man, told his wife he wants his Colacao like he is a kid talking to mommy, as if warming up milk is too hard for him. Deep down, I'm worried about her because, according to my mom, Mr. Douchebag is really hurting her, at least emotionally. She was crying with frustration while sharing this with her. It makes me sick that this guy really expects his partner in life to be a 24-hour maid. She should definitely divorce this guy immediately unless she wants to spend the rest of her life with a child in a grown man's body. Demanding his chalky milk be ready as soon as he gets home. Better put it in a sippy cup too for good measure. And when they grow old, he's gonna be in diapers too, so this whole thing is just gonna come full circle. And he's truly just gonna be an old man baby in diapers sucking on his chocolate milk with a sippy cup. This one's called, "Finish Your Call, Your Highness." I just got in from Costco, major mistake missing the morning hours, where we encountered this entitled parent. All registers are open, all lines are full, with the rest of the line running all the way down to the rear of the store. The register staff are completely swamped and doing their best to keep everyone moving. In front of us is entitled person. We'd crossed paths with her while shopping, oblivious to everyone while she gossiped on her phone. We weren't trying to eavesdrop, but she made it pretty hard. As her overflowing cart arrives at the register, without interrupting her conversation, she points to the cashier's assistant, then points to her cart, drawing a few circles over it, then points to the belt. The staffer stifles her incredulity at this piece of crap and loads up the belt while entitled person continues her conversation. The cashier rang her up while the other person loaded her cart. Entitled person blabbering on, pays, and prepares to walk away without a word of thanks. My daughter, who is 17 years old and works retail, looks to the cashier and in a raised voice says, "I'm sorry, some people are so rude." Suddenly, the woman stops, turns, and says to my daughter, "Excuse me?" I look to her and say, "Finish your call, Your Highness." She glared at us, those minimal functioning brain cells desperately thinking of a witty response before she gave up, returned to her call, and walked away. I love it. Nothing over the top or explosive, just one simple comment to let you know, "Hey, you're kind of a piece of trash." I love how she even turns around and responds to it with an "excuse me," as if she didn't know exactly what they were talking about. This was r/entitledpeople. Thank you for watching, all you awesome and beautiful viewers. If you enjoyed, drop a like and subscribe if you want to see more. See you later.